Hi everyone, thanks for joining me today for a new card showcasing the new It's a Boy, It's a Girl digital stamp set designed by Isabel Cristina Stamps. It's a magic iris card because I thought this die was just perfect to reveal a baby's gender. I started by cutting all the pieces using the magic iris die set and add-on by Lanfon. I have my sentiment It's a Girl that I cut using the ring die. I have the arrow handle, the tab, 3 sausage pieces, 3 rings, 3 stabilizers and the front panel. I kept one of the rings and used the flux capacitor die to cut 3 slits and 3 stitch brackets out of this ring. Next, I took one sausage piece, placed it into a slit and lined up this sausage piece with the inside edge of the ring. I temporarily taped it using washi tape and did the same thing with the two other sausage pieces. Next, we can see 3 X marks on the sausages. This is where I added glue dots. One glue dot on each X mark. I took a second ring, placed it on top of the sausages, and pressed down firmly to connect the sausages with this ring. Next, I removed the tape that was keeping the first ring and sausages together, and I used that same washi tape to, this time, keep the first and second ring together. Now we can see the stitch brackets at the back of the ring. This is where I'm going to add the stabilizers. So I started by applying double-sided tape on those bracket spots from the inside edge of the ring to the outside. I removed the backing paper and then I attached the 3 stabilizers right up against the inside edge of the ring. I flip the ring over and next I attach the tab at the right of one of the stabilizers. I place the tab following the curve of the ring and made sure to create a V shape with the stabilizer. Next, I applied double-sided tape on the stabilizers. I placed the last ring and I folded the stabilizers to secure this last ring, making sure not to be too tight or the mechanism won't work. I removed the washi tape and tried the iris to see if it was working well. Next, I applied liquid glue at the back of the arrow handle and I stuck it to the tab, making sure to align it with the ring. And then I trimmed off the piece of tab that was peeking out. Next, I applied double-sided tape on the stabilizers and liquid glue on the rest of the ring. I removed the backing paper and kept the iris closed. I placed the iris behind the front panel, making sure to line up both the circle in the middle and the arrow tab at the top right-hand corner. Next, I cut a card base out of cream cardstock and also a stitch rectangle out of a pink pattern paper. I started by attaching the pink pattern paper on the card base. Next, I temporarily taped the front panel to the card base. I applied liquid glue at the back of my sentiment and I tucked it right in the middle on the front panel. Next, I applied a bunch of foam squares at the back of the front panel that I finally attached on the card base. To decorate my little scene, I started by cutting birch trees out of white wood grain cardstock, and I applied vintage photo distress ink on those trees. Next, I cut a grass border and a cloud border that I will use as foliage, and I colored both elements using shabby shutters and peel paint distress inks. I attached the borders using double-sided tape, as well as the birch trees using liquid glue. Like always, I printed my images on Nina Solar White cardstock using my Epson printer. I cut them using my Scan and Cut and colored everything using my Spectrum Noir markers. When the coloring was done, I attached those cute images using foam squares. For the flowers, I started by giving them a little bit of dimension and then I stuck them using liquid glue. For a little touch of sparkle, I added a few clear sequins here and there. And finally, I added yellow nouveau drops in the center of each flower. And that's it. All done and super cute, I think. Thank you so much for watching and see you next time. Bye!